standing fewer than 20 feet from a 1969.5 Citroen DS parked in the shade of Point Mugu Rock, just a few miles north of Malibu on the Pacific coast. The owner of the car, Jeff C., Instagram's pinhead, is explaining the startup procedure and, instead of actually listening, I'm nervously shuffling from foot to foot, secretly hoping the iconic rock will loose from its eternal moorings, roll as rocks do, and crush enough of the car that I can go home early. It's not that I want the world to lose another weirdo French car, but I'm about to drive my hero, a car I've loved for decades, and I'm petrified that it won't live up to my expectations. And if that happens, I don't know what I'll do with myself, or my eBay search settings. Jeff hands me the keys and walks confidently over to the passenger side. His nonchalance is only adding to my stress. How do I start it again? I forgot. Better he thinks I'm an idiot than learns the truth that I was trying to use telekinesis to destroy his baby. I flop into the world's most comfortable seat and sink into what feels like 20 inches of foam and leather, click the key into the ignition, which is tucked between my legs right under the monospoke steering wheel, and reach for the starter button just to the right. Nothing can stop it now, I'm finally going to drive a Citroen DS. If you're looking for a full history on the DS, the rabbit hole goes as deep as you want. It's a fascinating car from a truly fascinating company, so I'll be brief. It's October of 1955 and the Paris Motor Show is in full swing. Across the pond this year, America saw the introduction of the straight edges of the Tri-5 Chevy and Ford's Thunderbird. But even Europe, a little more daring that year with the Carmen Ghia and Mercedes 190, wasn't ready for what the French were about to drop. It would also help to remember at this time that Citroën was selling the snail-shaped, built for rural farmers 2CV and the traction of van which debuted in 1934 looking like something from 1929. The sheets came off. The world's collective jaw dropped. Citroën recorded 80,000 pre-orders, with deposit, before the show closed. It wasn't just that the DS was a visual stunner, either. The DS was front drive with the engine mounted far behind the front axle and the transmission mounted in front of the engine. It featured inboard brakes. But the big news was the hydraulic system. Instead of simply assisting the brakes and the steering, the hydraulics on the DS gave life to the self-leveling suspension and the clutch, too. This is why Citroën DS ownership is so terrifying and exciting. We'll be right back.